What a thing to walk in on. Me dead. And I probably missed my world quest here. Yep. Missed it. Pity. So I messed around with arms because I'm thinking of having arms as my secondary spec on my warrior. I tend to run prot, and survivability is difficult when you get used to protection. It just is. And yeah, I'm gonna go back to this just for this one here. So yeah, looking at arms, messing around with arms, getting something set up for that, trying to get my artifact weapon up a bit so that I can spec into it, as you can see. Whereas with this one, I've kind of done a bit of work. For Fury, I accidentally applied some stuff to it, so he's got things. And then for Strumkar the Warbreaker, you can see I've got a few things here too. So I'm desperately used to my prot spec and the survivability that comes with it. This guy though, holy buckets. Okay, I need to pay attention because he's got something that just straight up rips into my stuff. I noticed it a fair bit with my arms because I freaking got tore up like butter. But it's almost like every time I hit him, it just does that much more damage back to me. Would have been nice if the Boonkin here decided to try and at least heal me a little bit, but hey. Oh man. And I swear I soloed him too. Last time I released it about this level, and you know what? He got away without me getting credit for it. So you get to sit here. I'm gonna do the lazy thing. I'm gonna sit here and watch him die. You can hate me all you want for it, but hey, my choice. So yeah, prepping arms a little bit, playing around with it, did LFR with it just to get used to how things work on that. I don't know. It's not Fury. I can definitely see where it's putting out more damage than Fury did. It's a little more slow-paced than Fury was. And I've got to say, I don't know. I can see its potential over Fury a whole lot more, and its abilities to do things a whole lot more. But I always loved Fury. I always loved Fury. We're right back to where we started. Me running back dead. You know, it's just a pain. Anyway, I'm not going to talk about Warcraft. There's a lot of people that talk about Warcraft, and honestly, I'm probably not skilled nor special enough to really talk a whole lot about it. My whole thing right now is just kind of talk about where things are going. You know, I'm not sitting at I'm not sitting on too many subscribers, so chances are you're probably not even gonna hear this when it's relevant. So I've got a 1 hour long, I kid you not, session that I did with my Wild Arms playthrough, and I'm hesitant to put it up because it's ridiculously long. But I cannot find any good breakpoints in it without it just being disproportionate. So 15 minutes on one end versus 45 minutes on the other, or 45 minutes on one end with 15 on the other. I do that every time too. I'm gonna post it anyway. So it's just going to be there, and it's going to be long, and we'll just see where things go from there. Can't really re-record it because I kind of save over where I'm at each time I was playing through, and I hadn't realized how long it got by the time I went to save. I just saved right over the thing. Actually, in hindsight, let's see if I even saved. I'm starting to think I didn't. I will have to see about that. So, that'll be fun. Oh, always an adventure when you're... It was a Scotch night. It was a Scotch night. Yeah, we'll go with that. That's my excuse, and I'm sticking to it. Also, going to be taking a look at something that's on Steam right now that's receiving a lot of attention, simply because it is, well, maybe a bit controversial, I don't know. And that is going to be Paladins from Hi-Rez Studios. I played a fair bit of Smite back in my heydays. Never could get into it hardcore competitive. It's fun enough, and I may go back to it one of these days, not sure. But the Paladins title that they released recently, it's early access, I believe, right now. Yep, early access right now. And it's catching a lot of flack because people are comparing it to Overwatch. I can see where they're getting those parallels from. Absolutely can see where they're getting those parallels from. And I haven't played it yet, so I can't speak from a gameplay perspective, but I can speak from a developer's perspective and say that the amount of time that it would take to release an Overwatch clone is not necessarily conducive to, or not necessarily aligned with, the development timeline that Paladins looks to have had. That was a long development cycle, I can tell from the detail and the work that went into it, the refinement that they've got on a lot of the stuff here. So I'm not sure it's a clone of Overwatch. I'm more convinced that there's just you know, a lot of the Overwatch characters are based on a lot of archetypes that can be found out and about in the world. And a lot of the Smite characters, not just Hi-Rez in general, but just going off of Smite, are also based on a lot of those same archetypes, only with a bit more of an interesting leaning towards mythological. And, you know, those all came from stories long ago. Just like Warcraft here, you know, look at your Valkyrie and your Halls of Valor. I mean, this is literally Valhalla with the Valkyries and your nice little Nordic ancestry showing throughout a lot of this stuff here. And this is all, even this is all borrowed from archetypes. So realistically, you could say that Warcraft stole a lot from, you know, your I think I almost called them Nords. So kind of going back to Elder Scrolls and all that kind of stuff. In a nutshell, there's a lot of things that get shared and all that kind of stuff. And sometimes when you're using a same or a shared source influence, you know, there is bleed over, there is crossover. So I'm not so worried with the whole, Paladins ripped off Smite, or I'm sorry, Paladins ripped off Overwatch, or it's just an Overwatch clone, or what have you. I'm thoroughly convinced that the stars just happen to align on those, and they, you know, they just happen to look remarkably similar, and there's nothing wrong with that. You know, Smite's got a really strong MOBIC following Smite. Hi-Rez. Hi-Rez has a very strong MOBA following with Smite, and Warcraft, or Blizzard, has a very strong following with a lot of its stuff, with Overwatch, Starcraft, and all that, things like that. And you know, it's gonna come down to a really big giant versus a really niche specialist fighting for a crowd that is going to pick one over the other. And that's just the way of it. So you know, it'll be interesting. I can't wait to test it out and see what it's like. I have high hopes for it. And we'll just have to wait and see. As far as other things are concerned, I did try to do the Hearthstone recording for this week, the Brawl. Didn't like it all too much. The Brawl was kind of dull. It's a three-peat of something that's happened, or that one that's come up a few times before. A lot of randomness, and nothing wrong with random. I like random, but, you know, it's been done to death, and I think I played a few rounds, not even enough to really make a proper recording, and I got bored with it. I really did. Four wins in, that was about it for me. I may start messing around with some fun decks and Constructed. I've got a Dragon Paladin that I've been tweaking for the last while now that I really enjoy. It doesn't get me anywhere because I don't play long enough to really get anywhere anyway, but it's a fun one. I enjoy it. There's something satisfying about dropping that big old Deathwing on turn 10, and they try to kill it, and then all of a sudden dragons everywhere. Also going to be messing around with some other PS3 stuff. I haven't quite settled on a title yet, but I know I want to. The Wild Arms one's going to be long, and I'm thinking of doing some quicker series like that. Still not sure what, though. I've also looked into the possibility of doing some fun stuff with Armello. I enjoy that one. I had that botched Rot Victory attempt not long ago, and I really, really, really still want to get a Rot Victory in. Really do. And you know, we'll just have to keep trying at that one. But I do intend to... the Infernal Lord. I really do intend to finish that one, and hopefully I can, plain and simple. For some reason or another, that is the only one that escapes me. Gosh, I want to get that one done. Rot Victory would be a blast. Oh, there goes my phone. Thank you, phone. What else? So I've got that. Tempest. Yes, Tempest. I will be getting another Tempest session done. I enjoy that one too much to just let it go. It's definitely been a fast or fantastically fun game. And I'm probably not going to do too many of the side quests on that one and strictly focus on the main story arc. And see where that goes, and maybe do the side quest after just so people can see them, because the side quests do get repetitive. You know, there's a few of those events that pop up every now and then, which are kind of nice little flavor, but the side quests are all repetitive. Once you do them, it just takes a few days and the same one unlocks again and you rinse repeat. The main draw is the story arc, so I will be looking at the story arc to get that one done. And I might be, you know, I might try to do some Warcraftian things here. I don't do near enough on my channel. I've got a playlist for it because I threw one thing in there for the Charred Locket that dropped in the Broken Shores event for pre-launch. And that was about it. I have recorded a few things, but nothing really substantiative. And I should do more. I spend a majority of my free time on Warcraft, and I just tend to chill, mainly. I don't do anything necessarily competitive or absolutely fantastically remarkable, but, you know, every now and then I may do something absolutely insane that warrants, you know, throwing out there, and we'll see. So, you know, like this one here, I'm kind of babbling incessantly, and that's about that. I may do some vlog-style stuff. I don't know. Talk over this and be like, hey, you know, this is what's going on, like I'm doing right now. And nothing wrong with that either. I don't know how I picked up all these imps, but I did. So what else can I do? Let's see. I wouldn't mind a request here or there. You know, there's a lot going on that, you know, the world's a crazy place and there's lots to talk about. We've got, aside from what are arguably the most entertaining elections I have ever seen going on in the U.S. right now, I've got some other things going on that, you know, that can warrant some discussion as well. What did I do? Why did I think this was a good idea? Put me up here. Golly. Gosh, I still had one. Thank goodness. Where am I going? Going over here. This is how not to warrior. Actually, this is just how not to do anything. Yeah, but I missed the crowd. That's alright. We'll recover a bit. So yeah, I can do more Warcraft things, just talking to things. We got the entertaining elections, like I was saying. I could say who I'm gonna vote for, but at this point, I'm not even sure. They are both of the candidates right now are. If I had to rank them on a scale of 1 to 10, I'm not sure a single one of them would break a 2. It's a tough one. It is absolutely a tough one, and we'll just have to see where things go on that end. Oh god, and I'm back in the slime. There we go. Can I hit him? Thank you. Let's see. What else? House sold. That's a good thing. So I will be looking for a new place here soon. Little insight into that. I'm comfortable where I am right now. As far as location goes. But I don't want it to be a permanent thing. I'm not necessarily. Can you come up here? Come up here, please. Gosh, why must you hold him in the lava? Screw you. Thank you. It's a middle of nowhere place. It really is a middle of nowhere place. And it's not a cozy, quaint middle of nowhere place like, you know, small town USA. This is literally the middle of a desert in the middle of nowhere, nestled right up against the border of Mexico. And I don't know. The work is good. I love what I'm doing as far as work. I like the people I'm working with. And I could live here conceivably forever. It bores me, to live here. There's a whole lot of nothing. How do I not have your flight path yet? Gosh. Right. We're going for a flight path swim hunt thing. Yeah, I don't know how I don't have your flight path yet. I could have swore I had it. So. Righty. So I'll talk while I swim. Yeah, no, it's... Oh gosh, these guys. It's just one of those things. I don't know. It would kind of be like, yeah, you work because you got to work because you need the income to support, sustain yourself. But as far as location goes, I don't know. I would be, if this company were located anywhere else, I would be probably absolutely happy. If I had a nice wooded park I could go for a walk in, because down here all we have is wide open nothingness, I would be happy. If I had trails that I could take my truck on, I would be happy. But there is none of that here. This place literally has nothing. And I think that's the most painful part about it. There's, you know, for free time, you don't have anywhere you can go. You don't have anything you can do. You don't have anything to keep you occupied, busy, entertained. You know, I start hobbies and then just tear right through them because there's nothing else to do but do your hobbies. I picked up archery and inside of a year, worked myself up from a 50-pound bow to a 70-pound bow. I can hit my bag from about 70 yards. I can, you know, I started getting things ready for bow hunting, because bow hunting's really big here in Texas. And then I ran out of that to do, so I moved on to the next thing, and the next thing was black powder. So I bought myself a couple of black powder rifle kits, built those, stained those, put those together, took them out to the range, got used to shooting them, and I've gotten pretty good to the point that I can take them out to about 300 yards now. 300 yards on iron sights using old Civil War technology, and then I ran out of that to do. That's ominous. And then I said, you know what, I should finish my truck. I bought a truck in 2013 that I've slowly been building up for expedition type driving, and so I took it out to the garage and started working on that, finished up the suspension work, dressed it up really nice and got it looking sharp and capable, and finally put the front and rear bumpers on it, installed the winch, and then I ran out of truck to work on. And the sad thing is, in this particular area, that's it. I'm running out of things to do. And that's actually why I picked up a lot of this recording stuff and started doing things like this. Because I just have free time and I want to do something that seems productive. And this is productive. Well, I'll say it's productive. It's me actually doing something that's not just for me. Others can enjoy it and watch it and see it and all that stuff. This is, you know, this is me really spending time, killing time with whatever I can, and then trying to make it something that I can share with others. So you know, that's just the gist of it, I guess. Is it sucks down here. It just sucks down here. Actually, I'm going to save those because I think I'm going to do something with my professions. I'm just not using my blacksmithing all that much. That's it. A fortified armor set. I'm going to cry. That's okay. So yeah, you know. So that's kind of the history here, and like I was saying, the house that I'm in currently is just sold it off because I don't want anything permanent down here anyway, and I'm going to find myself an apartment out in town, and I'll just live cozy in the apartment and work and do the things that I've been doing right now anyway, And then I'll, you know, probably take things from there and see where things go. And who knows? Maybe I'll wind up getting a job in one of the places I would enjoy. Minnesota would be nice. Missouri would be okay. Kansas would be beautiful. Anywhere East Coast, Florida would be a dream come true. I have lived on the West Coast. I'm familiar with the West Coast. It's a little too expensive for me. When I look at the cost of living gap between West Coast and East Coast, it's significant. But you know, we'll see. And then who knows? Maybe I'll actually end up getting some work in my degree instead of working in my experience. Well, I've got some experience in my degree as well, but for those who don't know, my degree is actually in game design. I have been working a little bit with a freelance company that I've been enjoying pretty much, doing some mobile stuff, and hoping to build up my resume so I can put that out there. But then I've also got 14, let's see, 2000. Yeah, I've got 14 years of experience in my current line of work. Between military and commercial stuff, and it's hard to break away from that. It really is hard to break away from that, and I enjoy it. I really do. I would much rather prefer to be working in my degree path, but you know, things happen for, you know, all kinds of unknown reasons, and this is just the way things went. I wound up working supply chain and logistics in the military, and it carried over to civilian life, and it continues to carry over, and I do pretty good with that. The hard part comes in trying to change over, you know, trying to port that 14 years of experience into the game design world is hard. I've got the management and team leading and all that kind of stuff and the project management side of it down. It's just the actual development that I don't have experience in. And really, they're looking at resumes and portfolios, and I still need to build up my portfolio a bit. So that's kind of why I'm enjoying working with this company that I'm working with right now. It may be freelance, it might not be a paid gig, but hey, we're starting to put some stuff out, and at least I can build my portfolio. So yay for that. Things are working, and we'll see how that goes. Let's see, what else can I talk about as I continue to kind of slow boat my way across the Broken Isles? Should have bought some potions for this. Let's see. I guess I am keeping myself busy. Between my freelance stuff, between work, between stuff like this, I'm keeping fairly busy. I'll say that much. But I miss some of the things that I used to do that I just can't do around here. I've climbed mountains, I've hiked trails, I've done mountain biking, off-roading, and a lot of other things like that, and with none of it here, you start to miss it. You really do start to miss it. I would love to be more involved outdoors. There is no outdoors here, and I think that's probably the single most disagreeable thing about being where I'm at is just that, and that's just a shame. But you know, hey, that's the joys of being able to do whatever we want, kind of a thing. Is I can work on getting out of this location and look at other things and see how that goes, and nothing wrong with that. Nothing wrong with that at all. Let's gather some things up for this guy here. So I do like how they structured world quests and stuff now, to where even though I'm not partied up with these people, we can help each other out. As a tank, I can pull in all the things, and as DPS, they can do their due diligence to slaughter it all. I'm not worried about dying, but hey, you know. That should be enough. So. Yep, and that's that. And of course, because these are Murlocs, we're going to keep getting a bunch of them. Murlocs. Whoever came up with the idea of Murlocs is a sadistic genius. My hat's off to them. I could have never come up with something quite so cruel. But they did well. They absolutely did well. So, I think I just got gold off of that, didn't I? Yeah. So, I need to work on getting my gold reserves back up. I've kind of been... Like I said, getting ready for a raiding and all that kind of stuff, I've kind of made liberal use of the auction house. Now, I still have a lot of things that I can sell, but I need to get those auctions running, and I need to get things sold so that I can recoup some of the investments I've made in the character to get things ready. So... Yeah. Tonight's going to be raid night. We'll see how that goes. But anyway, that's about all I've really got to ramble on about. I could probably find other things, but yep, just kind of wanted to throw a few things out there. This is some of the plans that I've got going ahead as far as content that I'm going to be putting up. And just some of the things coming in here. Like, I know when I move, it might slow down a bit. It's not that it's fast right now to begin with. But it could be a fair bit before I'm able to get things settled properly. Especially since at work we've got a few other things going on during that same time that are going to keep me fairly well occupied. It's just going to be remarkably busy. Who knows? Maybe if Samsung gets their head out of their asses and actually gets some functional phones out there, I can actually use those too. One of the cool things about the Samsung Note, for the brief time that I had it, was the fact that it has the ability to record games as well. So I could use that and record some mobile stuff and throw that up here and who knows, that opens up a whole new realm of possibilities as far as content put up here goes. But, you know, that's all dependent on the reliability of the Note 7. They're still having some issues with it from what I understand, and I believe the replacements aren't coming out until the end of the October month anyway, which is quite a bit of ways. But we'll see. Anyway, that's all I've got. I'm going to go talk to this guy and... see what this one does. Anyway, that's it. That's all I've got. I'm gonna play through an interactive story here, and then I think I've got the raiding coming up later. So goodbye, maybe? No, you know what? You get to see this. We'll see how this goes. Because okay, he makes things run. He does branches. Okay, so this is interesting. So he heals himself, and then he uses vines to kill things. And I think I only got one person. Golly. It'd be nice if I could target. Okay, there we go. I'm learning. I don't know why this is so. Let them come. Yeah, right. I am Furbolg, hear me roar. I may have bit off more than I can chew, but that's okay. So, warlords used to be like this. Quickly, gather all the things. They die, you don't. And there we go. Ah, that was easy. Was that it? That was it. Alrighty then. So, yeah. Go Furbolg. Yay. Good job, tree dude. Alright. Well, guess that's it. Have a nice night. Goodbye.